What's going on, everybody? Back again for another episode of Distorted Minds Podcast.
Woo! What's up? It's your boy, Tiny Wiener.
Tiny Wiener.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun one today. As always, Kevin and Keith in the house, and today we have a couple of new faces in the studio. We got Sloppy Joe Coppage.
What up, what up?
What it do?
And we got Brandon Gumm on the mic. Right. Fuck yeah! Before we get into the show, I'm going to do this first. First off, I'm going to, give Thomas the old shout out.
What up, Thomas?
And his show that's about to go on February 1st at Healer. We got King's Gambit on the bill, Sins of Calvary, Indomitable, of course, and one of my favorites, A Taste of War, motherfucker.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see. What else? Info. Doors is at 7, music at 8, fucking $8. Bring the ruckus. That's what it says on the thing.
Bring the ruckus.
So if you don't bring the ruckus,
can't come.
They're liable to kick you out.
They say fuck us, then bring the ruckus.
Dude, I can't wait. I'm going to that show for sure. Are you?
I'm trying to. Trying to get it off.
All right, well then let's just fucking kick into the song then. Get the jizz of it right, Keith?
All over.
Oh, dude. So what's going on, you guys? How's things?
Things are going. We're here.
Things are things.
Finally made it over.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Finally got you guys on.
Finally got to get here.
Sloppy Joe.
Sloppy Joe. Sloppy, Sloppy Joe.
Sloppy, Sloppy Joe. That's a great bit.
Know how your boys like it extra sloppy.
Lady, you're scaring us.
Oh, shit.
Look at extra sloppy. Sloppy.
Dude, I had... I want to give a shout-out to one of my buddies from back in the day in middle school. I mean, we weren't, like, super homies, but, like, we knew each other because we're both musicians and shit. But he, last week, was on Jimmy fucking Kimmel.
What?
Yeah, dude, with his band, I guess, man. He plays guitar. He was up there
fucking
rocking out, dude.
That's cool as shit, dude.
Fucking decent.
The band is called Scary Pool Party.
Scary
All Together.
Pool Party.
You heard of that?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
My dude was...
No shit!
That's my homie. Travis Couch, shout out to you, motherfucker.
What's
probably,
up?
Probably
right
never
on,
hear
Travis.
This.
I don't know you, but if it you, sounds
you,
awesome.
If you blow up, dude, send us, like, some crumbs or something. Give us a shout out or something on fucking late night or something.
Right? That'd be cool.
No, I'm just kidding, but, dude... That's pretty awesome.
Just make sure there's sunbeam crumbs. Huh?
Yeah. I watched the video too, man. Like I watched, looked it up on YouTube. I was like, this motherfucker.
That's
damn.
Awesome. Dude, well, yeah, congratulations, dude.
Yep.
Yeah.
But totally.
Totally
what's,
tubular.
What's new with you, Kiefer?
Not much, man. I just got back from cut my grandpa's hair.
Did you butcher him or what?
No, I think I did pretty all right. I mean,
it's
just cut. It, you just cut
for the
hair.
Clippers you had though, right?
Yeah,
yeah. I mean, number two buzz cut really hard for anybody, but
yeah,
just kidding.
That's
what I used
kinda,
to do.
Pretty much what I like. He just wanted it short so he didn't have to like
cause fuck
he
with it.
Got oxygen and shit, so he starts combing his hair and he gets out of breath, so he just like fucking
shit.
Just buzz it down. So I was like,
that's a man.
Shit, I could do that.
Anytime you bring up your grandpa, I just think about the truck. Can we talk about that?
Let's not.
I want to hear about truck, man.
That's all right.
As far as he knows,
he's not going to listen to this.
Maybe. I don't know, man.
Not one day.
God damn it, man.
Now people are wondering.
Yeah, you got to have the story out there.
Fucking oh, man. I guess.
Shit. I want to hear this so bad.
If you really don't want
it. Go for it, I guess. I don't want to leave everybody hanging. Let's go for it.
I have no idea what the fucking truck story's about.
It's not even that funny, but I just... When he saw it, I was just like, oh, shit, look at that.
You borrowed his truck for a while.
And then he's like, you could have just told me. I have insurance. They would have fixed it. I was like,
dude,
I don't know what you're talking about.
I wasn't there.
Right. It wasn't me.
I was like, well, shit. I didn't notice until you said something about it.
God.
Dude. Left a big old dent in the back, in the back bumper.
It's still there.
Like,
the bumper just went.
Who was at the Emerson? Was my band playing? Who was playing that night? Yeah, my band, right?
You left something, but I think you guys were playing, and you left something inside.
Oh, yeah.
You were like, fuck, I left
my dignity.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm like, what? Was that? Oh, no, my giant purple double-sided dildo. I can't live without that. No.
Dude, I went to the Emerson once, and I was dating a chick that was, I was like 21. She was 19.
Yeah.
So we went and seen her buddy's band, which they fucking blew. So I walked my happy ass right across the street to the fucking bar. Started playing. It gets better. Started playing darts with this dude. He starts buying me beers, right? Just like beer after beer. I'm like, damn, man. Like, I appreciate it. And he's like, yeah, I'm gay. And I was like, whoa. Righteous, dude.
Too much. God,
these beers taste a lot better now. Never in my life. Dude, yeah, ended up inviting me and her like to his gay fucking hot tub chili cook-off Super Bowl something, dude. And I was like, no. Probably won't be there, man. Hot think, you know, just something just came up.
And he was like, you ain't got to tell me.
Yeah. I just went from 6 to midnight.
So, like, how long have we known each other? A couple of years now, or what?
I think so, yeah. Like 2 years, yeah, something like that.
Met through a mutual friend, but Joey here's a dude I like to jam acoustic guitar with.
Hell yeah, it's
awesome. Which we haven't done in a while.
No, we haven't.
Yeah, it has been a while.
We gotta do that.
We gotta do it.
I'm down to jam something tonight if you want.
What's
after this?
Fuck, man.
Let's do it.
Sounds like the finger's going in the butthole right now.
The tight butthole.
Right. Axl Rose. Damn.
And then I
pulled my wiener out.
This is my wiener.
Wouldn't that be fucked up though, man? Just walk like what if that's how we had to wear jeans, dude, and just what everybody walk around with their fucking dicks out of their fucking fly, you know?
Do you ever had to wear those little
just swinging around.
Little nut hugger shorts gym class?
Oh, that was
like,
worst.
We had like little super tight little purple shorts that you had to wear in gym class, fucking just got like the whole outline of your dick showing, just jumping around.
So, I mean, making
you run laps. Go up to the teacher. Why are you all sweaty? You're not even running. Go run.
And we wonder why teachers fuck students these days. I mean. Damn it. Yeah, I mean, I wrestled, dude, for a long time. So I mean, the singlet, you know, that's not real fun to wear.
I bet not.
It's not, dude. It's really gay. I often think about this. And, yeah.
What was I doing?
I'm kidding, man. Wrestling's an awesome sport, man. But yeah.
Dude.
You want girlfriends, man, just show them an outline of your fucking cock, dude. While you're on the mat with another dude, that's cool.
They don't
want
to see
an
outline of my cock.
Makes sense.
It's weird shaped.
Right.
It makes a hard left turn halfway down.
Everybody, dude, the whole bucket, everybody in the school gymnasium's looking at you and shit. Like, what, there's something wrong with that guy right over there, man. Look at that. Is this supposed to bulge out like that? I'm not sure.
Wiener jokes.
Yeah. I did get to wrestle a girl one time, though, and it was, dude, I stomped her ass, bro.
Okay. You just said that on record.
Dude. I mean, what I meant to say was I won. My coach is like, go out there and show no mercy. And I was like, wow.
You got it, boss.
Wow. Right. Okay.
No mercy. Okay.
But, yeah. Anyway.
So dude, I broke her neck.
Did you hear that Walmart is in the news?
Walmart's in the news.
Is it? Again?
Yeah, they fucked up.
What did we do?
What did they do now?
Don't
they slash prices again?
No, because when Walmart's in trouble, it's a we issue.
I guess, like, someone who represents them on some social media or something fucking tweeted something that, like a Paul Walker joke that was...
really?
That's kind of fucking dirt.
Like, I don't remember what it was for.
Hey.
But it was like, hey, Paul Walker, click it or tick it.
Oh, dang.
Which is from Workaholics.
They stole that. Too soon.
They stole that from Workaholics.
Oh, that's my goodness. Up. That's fucked up.
Apologized and deleted it.
Why would you say that?
I wish I would have read more of the article, but fucked up, dude.
What a terrible person. Do you think that's what St. Peter told him at the pearly gates? Like, click it or tick it.
I love it, dude. Workaholics is hilarious. You guys watch that shit?
Yeah, I can't say I watch really much of anything, but I have seen that show a few times. It's pretty decent.
Fucking hilarious.
It's funny.
And that movie, too.
Yeah, the movie was real funny.
Game on, man.
Oh, I have seen that, dude.
That's fucking funny.
That's pretty funny.
You guys seen my butthole?
Hey, did you guys see that picture that was floating around Facebook that was you know, Ethan Suplee from like Randy from My Name Is Earl and shit.
Oh yeah. Oh, he's all super jacked now.
He's fucking jacked, dude.
He's fucking huge.
He looks good as fuck.
I was like, god damn. He looks kind of scary now.
Doesn't look like the same person at all.
No. I know, dude. You can tell, like, you gotta see it in his face, like you can tell by his eyes and shit.
I thought it was,
but just looking at him, like, damn, that fool is buffed out.
Yeah, dude.
He's yoked.
And then it showed like the old picture when he was in like American History X.
He
was like fucked super huge.
And when he was in is that what that was?
Remember the
Butterfly Effect. He was pretty big in that one.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot he was in Butterfly Effect.
Yeah, yeah, that was his buddy.
Remember
Ashton Kutcher's buddy.
One of the greats
right
there.
Yeah. That was good.
Dude, that was cool.
Yeah, he's beast mode now.
You say he's a beach bum?
No, he's a beast.
Oh. I was like, damn.
He's a beach bum now.
Oh, shit.
I wouldn't mind being a beach bum.
Right.
Hey, if you had to be any kind of bum, the beach would be the best one.
Fuck yeah.
Can I be a booze hound?
Not till you're 16.
Ooh, another damn. Simpsons reference coming out of Sector 7G.
Right.
Smithers. Who are those men?
Every time.
Seems to be Kevin Hill and Keith Holland from Sector 7G, sir.
No. Fucking
Zeppelin rules.
Doyle rules. I think The Simpsons is probably like one of the shows where like start getting you like doing impressions, because you just hear everybody and then you're sitting there laughing and you do the impression sitting back. And
yeah, there's
a
like
while,
five people doing like 30 different characters and shit.
That is crazy.
Think you'll come again.
Right.
Eat my shorts, dude.
Yeah. Speaking of Abu, I don't think
yeah.
it's,
He's not going to voice him anymore. Getting rid of Apu.
Yeah, I just read something today about
me
that.
Me too. I've seen it on the stupid internet.
Why?
The what stupid fuck? Internet.
Yeah, not the smart.
That is so true.
Not the smart internet. The dumb one.
Yeah, the stupid
one. So what, are they going to get rid of anybody with dummies. Any kind of accent because it may be offensive to somebody somewhere at some time, eventually, possibly?
Somebody's already offended.
I mean, really what needs to happen, dude, is just people need to grow a pair of fucking balls. Like with hair on them and everything, dude. Like
yeah,
the whole
man.
Thing.
It's fine for the last 30 years, right?
Dude, I'm so tired of it, man.
Damn.
Dude, I mean, what can you do these days without offending
somebody?
Did
you hear Dave Chappelle's speech at the when he got the Mark Twain Award?
No.
I heard the Ricky Gervais one.
He's defending stand-up hardcore. He's like, it's an art form.
Yeah.
You know? It's fucking jokes.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's not reality. Yeah. It's a fucking joke.
Like, you pay knowing that it's going to be
right
offensive to somebody.
Right.
I mean, shit.
I know. Can you imagine being that motherfucker who pays for a fucking comedy show and then just storms out? Like, you're the dumbest motherfucker.
Right.
Right.
Well, have you guys caught the new Mike Epps one on Netflix?
Oh, my God.
Is it good?
Mike Epps got a new one?
It's probably the best stand-up I've seen in, like, 10 years, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Hands down, dude. I laughed from start to finish.
And he offends
I laughed
everybody.
The entire time, bro.
I think I just saw, didn't Kevin Hart have a new one out?
I think it's something
it's
else.
Like, yeah, it's like a documentary.
Yeah,
oh, is that
cool.
What it is?
That's cool, though.
Okay.
It's like a series, isn't it? Is it a series?
I think
it's a
full-blown. I haven't checked it out, but I've seen it on Netflix.
Just a movie?
Movie, yeah.
But, yeah, from what I gathered, it was like a documentary.
I watched about half of it, and it was pretty cool.
You can't beat Tom Segura, though. He's the top dog.
That was the best.
Yeah, I showed you guys Tom Segura that one time when we got all drunk here.
DJ, I just thought about this, man. Do you think Kevin Hart has ever written a self-help book called How to Be Small?
No, it's called From the Heart.
I don't know why I just thought of that. I was just like, from the heart. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, man. I don't know why. That just popped in my brain. I was like, damn, I wonder if he has done that.
Man.
I mean, he talks about it all the time. He's like, his kids are whipping his ass and shit. Like, I don't know what to do with that. Like, damn,
I like him. He's decent.
Yeah, he's good, man. I'm just all jokes aside, he's
I've been watching a lot of fucking Doug Benson, Getting Doug with High. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
It's not that funny. He's not my favorite comic, but he's all right. You know what I'm saying? But
right.
He has good guests getting high with him.
Right.
I saw like Trailer Park Boys and Workaholics.
Yeah.
Fucking Anthony Jeselnik. I just watched that one.
Yeah, I've been watching a little bit of Anthony Jeselnik.
I like him a lot, dude.
Yeah.
He's funny as hell.
He's funny.
Offensive like a motherfucker.
Jimmy Carr and Ricky Gervais.
Oh, yeah, dude. It's great.
Jimmy Carr, I didn't think he was that. He's like a British.
I'm waiting for another Jim Jeffries.
Yeah, Jim Jeffries is funny.
That dude's
as fuck,
hilarious.
Yeah.
Did you see his show? Legit?
Yeah.
It's a good show.
And Wilfred. I've seen both the Australian and the American.
Wilfred.
Yeah.
That reminds me of Pearl Jam. When he was like, I'm
what
just
are you
sitting
drawing?
Here drawing pictures of mountaintops. With him on top. Lemon yellow sun. Arms raised.
In a V.
He's just talking it though, and he like really drew it.
It's so funny. I was
drawing it like fucking Bob Ross, just painting a picture for you.
Happy little.
And it's like, Daddy never gave. Painting his dad and shit.
Speaking
turning
of painting,
away, like, not
Sarah's
painting
got a podcast
attention.
Coming out at some point where they do painting and shit and talk about various topics. If you guys want to listen to her, check that out, and I'll let you know. When to check it out. It's not up yet. It's not up yet.
Just an announcement. Yeah.
Oh, it's funny, dude. She was like giving me some dome.
Okay.
And then and like playing around like I was like stick it in your ear and shit.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
And then they're like and then I called it a wet willy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we went there, folks. We went there.
But then, wait, we're not done yet.
We're not.
Oh, shit.
After she was done, she was like, you want breakfast now? Head and breakfast.
Head and breakfast.
A lot of good puns fucking going on. Great.
You know that? That sounds so delightful.
It was really a good time.
Oh, man.
Does she listen to these?
She said it like afterwards. She was like, you're probably going to say that on the podcast, aren't you? I was like, is it cool to do it? She was like, yeah, it's funny.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, that's a good sport.
But my mom does listen to this sometimes.
Oh, your mom does?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Hi, Mom.
Hello.
She's going to be like, that boy.
That boy ain't right.
We still got to try to switch out that picture.
Oh, yeah. Did you see the picture of Keith and Jesus? There's a picture at my mom's house of Jesus, but it looks like Keith. Here, I'll show you.
Allegedly.
Let me find it.
Allegedly. We gotta have a poll on the page.
Oh. Here you go. Check it out.
No shit.
He is, folks. He finally came back.
So Keith brought it up on the last episode. He was like, we should go in, we should take that picture that I took, put a sketch filter on it, black and white, and then like switch it out with my mom's picture and see if she noticed.
Damn.
See how long it takes.
Oh my goodness.
It'd be better to have like a hidden camera.
Yeah.
Right.
Surprise.
I just hope you don't have any Jewish friends, because they'll notice immediately, dude. That's not Jesus. That ain't him.
Drew called him Trailer Park Jesus.
It's not him, guys.
Drew called him Trailer Park Jesus.
Trailer Park Jesus. Oh, peace be with you, and an extra piece for you, buddy.
You know what made me laugh, dude, on the last episode, too, is when I was like, you want to land this plane? You want to port this boat? And you're like, as long as there's no docking.
Damn.
No way. That was like the funniest shit you ever said so far, Keith.
Holy shit, that's real life.
And then we were like, Google it.
Google it. Google it.
Everybody's playing this way. Google it.
Google it.
Oh, shit.
Alexa.
Oh, motherfucker, what?
Holy shit.
Alexa, look up docking. Urban Dictionary.
It's fucking real, man. Google it.
Not cool.
That's what everybody says.
Oh, God.
What kind of topics you got, Keith? Anything good?
Maybe, I'm not sure.
You don't even know?
I was watching...
We should look at each other's notes and be like, okay, this.
This doesn't work.
I got a bunch of old notes that I kind of got to, like, go, that I've already talked about, and get those out.
Sure.
And recycle some shits.
Let's talk about some music, dude.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know what to talk about, really, but...
I
know Celine Dion did a really good job in Titanic.
Yeah,
but
that one ended up shaking.
Yeah. Oh.
What have you been listening to lately, dude?
Dude, I listen to a lot of old school stuff.
Just the same shit for centuries?
No, I mean, not. Well, when it comes to classic rock, dude, I'm kind of getting tired of that a little bit, because that's all I ever grew up listening to. But like 70s hip hop and R&B, dude, I really. The bass and shit. Dude, everything about that shit is really cool.
Fuck yeah.
Everything about it. I mean, dude, get me a fucking pair of bell bottoms, dude, and I'll do whatever you want me to do.
I'd be looking up like some oldies and shit too. Like,
yeah,
listen to that.
I was, you know,
it was just my imagination.
Right. So we're hanging out at Corey's the other night, and Amy comes over. It's Brandon's cousin, by the way, Amy.
Yeah.
But she brought over her sister, I think, and it was Donna. And as soon as I heard her name, because really, honestly, you don't hear, like, there's not too many females I know these days that, Donna's kind of like a rare name, dude. You don't hear it a lot, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's true.
So, she's like, yeah, my name's Donna, and I was like, I had a girl, and Donna was her name. Do 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 do. And since she met me, I've never been the same. Yeah. But I love my girl. Boom, boom. So I mean, cracks me. But I love oldies, man. I like that shit too.
Fuck yeah.
I mean,
cause that's like what my stepdad listened to growing up and shit. I was young, yeah. And always heard it. So it's, you know, it stuck.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's jamming. It's fucking jamming.
Angel,
yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Will
you be mine? Angel baby. My angel baby.
You know, I have never once been tempted to listen to the Temptations.
Really?
I have.
Shit. Well, you're right. I've never. No. I mean, you're doing that shit willfully. I mean, I'm listening to this shit.
It's good shit, man. I don't know. I think there's going to be a lot of good
Four Seasons
music this year.
Sweet. Oh.
Mastodon, I think, is coming out. I don't know, man.
Pearl Jam with their new album.
Oh, yeah. You guys were just saying that. Pearl
Jam's dropping a new album right here.
Pearl Jizz.
Gosh, man.
That would hurt.
They're about to jizz everywhere.
At least it wouldn't be as bad as a kidney stone, right? Dude, I'm fucking afraid of kidney stones. Oh, I've never had one, but
I haven't either. It scares me to death too, man.
It's fucking scary.
They saw. Like,
have you had one?
I haven't had one. Jen has.
I hear it feels like razor blades just slicing your dick off. Like,
yeah. No, I hear it's like a jagged ass fucking rock little thing.
Yeah.
Like it's not smooth.
like a stone?
Sometimes.
Like stones.
Sometimes they get so big you have to like pound them with a laser to like break them apart, break them down so they can pass through.
Oh my God, that's terrifying. Like, I don't know if I like that at all. I don't even want to think about that.
Peeing out a rock.
Yeah, man. Tell you what, man, how big of a man are you? Have you ever pissed out a stone?
Ask Dwayne Johnson.
A stone came out of your dick.
I pissed Dwayne Johnson.
You said I pissed Dwayne Johnson.
What? I missed it. What did he say?
He said I pissed Dwayne Johnson.
That's awesome.
A rock right there, buddy.
Fuck, man. Oh, my
that
God.
That is funny.
Fuck me to tears.
Nah, I don't want no part of none of that.
No, man.
Oh, God, stop.
Right, dude.
I can't get to the link from...
Talking about something bringing you to your knees.
But Jesus. There's a thing in here. It's like a restaurant in New York is given approval to serve human meat.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Where?
In New York.
Another reason to hate New York.
Yeah, I can't. I'm going to try to look it up.
Is it cheese pizza?
Don't go there for a vacation.
I want human on one half.
Right. Texas Chainsaw Massacre on the other.
I want the adult baby back ribs.
Holy shit. Holy shit.
You got to specify that.
Rump roast. I eat ass all the time.
Does that come with a side of kidneys? I'm not sure. Curious. I mean, because if it comes with a side of kidneys, probably take him one.
Fava beans.
So gross. Human meat, dude. I mean, how did...
Yeah.
I mean, that bothers me, dude. Like, it's so disturbing.
Yeah.
Like, you wouldn't try it? What if like desert island situation? Would you rather starve or would you rather eat someone?
Well, I would probably starve, bro.
Really?
Yeah, I'd just say, you know, honestly? What? This is the way I'm supposed to go out.
I was just watching a thing
about I can die peacefully knowing I didn't eat another fucking human being. That's what I would do.
What if you didn't have to kill the person first?
Yeah. Huh?
What if you didn't have to kill the person first?
So.
What if you knew someone was coming in a few days, but you knew you wouldn't make it? You would starve before then, so you had to
see,
take a couple bites.
Yeah. See, no, I don't know, man.
You can't say never. I'll just watch
you guys.
I had to raise the stakes a little.
I don't know.
Literally. Well,
okay. I think I would still just go with my way.
Yeah. So I just watched this thing about Cannibal Island in the Soviet Union in the 30s, like 1930s, 1830s, something like that. They
it's
had
a pretty big gap.
That's a 100-year gap.
Dude, I can't remember. I was listening to it as I was going to sleep, and I was like, this is fucked up.
Sweet dreams that night?
Oh, yeah, dude. That shit don't bother me.
They talk about on your mom's house.
Damn.
What?
How he's always watching murder shows when he's going to sleep.
Oh, yeah. And she's like, turn that shit off.
I didn't mean to derail you, though.
No. But they had like a bunch of shit going on, and they packed a whole bunch of people in these little farms, and then they started running out of food, so that they made this other place to put everybody. But then the guards, they gave them like it was like 100 pounds of rice or something like that to split between everybody, and they would bring more people in with the same amount of rice, so they would run out, and like eventually, I think this all happened within a couple of months, a month or so, they started like just eating each other, and like the guards would torture the people there.
It was a prison?
It wasn't supposed to be. It was just supposed, because they were running out of like food, money, and resources, so they were trying to like implement this law that if you didn't have your passport, you had to go get, you got arrested and went to this farm, work farm or something like that. But then they started like making up shit to get people arrested, just to like,
what were you listening to? Was it a podcast?
No, it was like some
documentary.
Yeah, history doc thing.
Oh.
Where they were talking about it, and like the only way they found out was because this lady made it out, but they had cut off her calves and ate it. But they would like, they got pleasure out of the torture and shit, and she somehow got somewhere, and she told somebody about it, and they kind of like, they arrested everybody, but they covered it up, and like with all the dead bodies, like over the summer, all the grass grew up over everything, so you couldn't really see what was going on unless you went out there and knew exactly where everything was. Right.
But you go out there, dude, and you're losing your calves. I mean,
well, they had already.
Now I'm wondering what a human calf muscle tastes like.
I know.
Yeah. Dude, it got.
Like, you want breast or thigh?
All jokes aside, right?
If you get home, just look it up, dude. It's fucking crazy.
I don't think Cannibal you would want to eat a human breast, would you?
Cannibal Island.
Cannibal Island. Yeah.
I mean, that's a human breast.
That wouldn't be a good meat,
I
right?
think they did that to a lady. They cut off
that's
both
a lot of
her.
That right there.
They cut off both of her breasts. They cut off, like, I think, like, her...
He's going dark.
It was...
Keith
it was,
wants to go dark today.
It was fucked up, dude.
Well, I'm just saying, I mean, if we're talking about titties on a female, I mean, I like to suck those, not eat them.
Yeah. I like to try and fit them all in my mouth, like...
Have you ever tried titty milk?
No.
It's
have you
it's
tried
different.
It? Is it good?
No. No, it's not. It's horrible.
Well, I don't think it's for you.
Well, it's not. It was for my daughter, but I mean, I had to try it. You know what I mean?
Make sure it's not poison.
Specially formulated.
Right. My kid's eating it. Why can't I? Yeah. Like, shit. She needs this shit. Maybe I need it too. So I tried it, man, and bitter.
Yeah.
Fuck me to death, dude. It was horrible. It was like, God, dude.
Need some sugar.
I mean, yeah. Well. Artificial sweetener in there. That, get that sweet and low end.
Put some
bitches.
Stevia in it.
Right. Right. Damn. How do we get on titty milk, man?
I don't know.
Better than almond milk.
This is like this is a pretty weird path we're going down.
Show me the tits on an almond.
Yeah. Almond milk. What the fuck is that?
Yeah. Wasn't that? Hey, I saw that video though, man. Did you guys see that floating around Facebook, man? The guy was showing you how to milk an almond.
No,
dude, it was fucking hilarious, bro. It was great, man. He's like, you the little teat down there. He's like, you can't even really. You gotta really look at it. He's like, you squeeze that bitch and she'll just spew everywhere. I was like, what the fuck? What am I watching?
You get her going.
Yeah.
One thing you want to stay off the internet.
Yeah.
For real. I'm going to scare the fuck out of
people come up with these days is crazy.
TikTok, man.
It's a wild one out there.
TikTok is horrible.
That one video.
It is gaining popularity.
It is.
You gotta watch people really everywhere you go.
I always get those cringe videos on my Facebook of the TikToks. It's the worst.
The worst.
What kind of videos pop up if you go to a like a Facebook video and then you like scroll down? What kind? Because ours is always different. Like me and him and Sarah's.
Like it's some of the people I follow, but like Caleb Francis, if you haven't,
I don't know
seen that,
that
dude's video. I mean, he's just he's big ding dong dude.
What does he do?
It's hilarious though, man. It's funny shit. But like I like Remco's Groove Lab dude. If you haven't checked him out, dude, the baddest bass player. I don't know, man. Yeah, he gets me. I tell you, man, blood's a pumping right now. I'm just thinking about
it. Gets me all jazzed up.
No, it's badass though, man. I like funk bass, man, and he's pretty fucking slick, dude. He did some shit on a fretless bass, and I was like, I'm done. I give up, man, because I don't know if I'll ever be able to get there or not. But
sure,
you don't know until you try.
You just gotta make a.
But it's sick. But yeah, stuff like that. Like I'll scroll through and it'd be like that dude, that comedian guy. Be some music shit. Like it's usually all the same kind of. Yeah,
mine's the same thing as just pranking people or UFC fights. That's all that pops up on mine.
Mine's all kinds of wacky, dude. I get like a bunch of different shit.
I get a lot of meme videos, meme compilation videos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the TikTok cringe videos.
I don't think you can get away from TikTok these days, though. That's just something that's
pop up
on terrible.
Everybody's stories or.
Right.
It's there.
Dude, I get like a whole bunch of like DIY project stuff where people are like making like epoxy tables or
that's pretty cool stuff.
Some kind of like light shit.
He's crafty.
Crafty. Yeah. Like,
some things you don't think you'd watch just becomes interesting.
Yeah.
You know, you're like, oh, it does. Man, can't
and
look
then
away.
Yeah, there's like those dudes that go out in the middle of nowhere and just like dig a secret like pool. Out in the middle of nowhere
right
with
on.
Bamboo and somehow fill it up and
right.
Yes,
yes.
Fucking
hey, right dude. Up. Last time we recorded, we fucking after we were done, we went out and got fucked up. didn't we keep? Am I allowed to say that?
Yeah.
But
man.
At the end of the night, we came up with a hilarious parody. Because our podcast drops every Monday. So we came up with every Monday there's a podcast waiting for me from my friends at Distorted Minds.
Nice.
That's good.
We gotta keep writing it, but so
to be continued.
Yeah, look forward to that, listeners.
I'm always laughing when
That's
I
awesome.
Tune in. I don't know.
And didn't understand. That's my jam, dude. He was also on Workaholics. Mark McGrath.
Yeah.
Sugar Ray.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just want to
put your arms around me, baby.
That's the good old school stuff right there.
Yeah. Wasn't he like punching people for a while that called him Sugar Ray or something like that?
Damn.
I just saw a video
Dude,
where you're fucking
20 motherfuckers out.
Guy.
I guess it's going to be my band name.
He was also in Scooby-Doo. Remember that?
Oh, yeah, he was.
Scooby-fucking-Doo.
I can't remember if that was a true thing or not. If he was like, because people were calling him like Sugar Ray, and for some reason he was getting pissed off. He's like, my name is Mark McGrath.
Mark McGrath.
I saw you, Sugar Ray.
Yeah.
Pretty sure I'm gonna have to take that halo away from that four-post.
Halo, I think of the Machine Head song, which I'm looking forward to that show. That's gonna be badass. You guys like Machine Head?
Absolutely.
I'm not real familiar. I mean, I think I've.
That's cool.
I think
it's
I've
heavy.
Heard them.
It's heavy. Look, it's these guys. Cool. Cool, man.
So I see you got Tim the Toolman Taylor up here.
Yeah,
what's
check it out.
What?
It's badass, right? It's fucking signed. How do you like that? Be nice.
That is cool.
Be good to your tools.
That's That's awesome.
That's what he wrote.
That is really fucking cool.
And I got that because Sarah, back in the day, they like in school, they had to write to like a celebrity. She chose like Spice Girls or something, but her brother wrote to Tim Allen. And her mom fucking kept that picture because he didn't want it. And like when she moved out here, she gave it to Sarah because she thought it was hers. And then Sarah gave it to me.
Dude, that is so fucking, that is so weird.
And I
dude,
fucking
because
love it, dude.
I did something in elementary similar, dude. Like I wrote to Cindy Crawford.
Cindy Crawford?
I mean, yeah, I understand.
With the mole?
Like, It's weird. It's the same assignment. But,
pick a hotter
fuck
check?
Yeah, dude. She's shit. I would probably.
I don't like the mole.
I'd probably like her a lot. But
it's distracting.
Anyways, I wrote Cindy Crawford, dude, and she
chop
fucking
it up,
mailed
some
me
guacamole.
A signed picture of her, dude, and it was like jack off material, dude, for like 6 months straight. Dude.
Write her back. Couldn't send a fucking nude.
I mean, like, well, I ended up throwing it away, you know.
Yeah.
Just when you get jizz on a picture that much, dude,
that much jizz,
it ruins everything.
It becomes worthless.
Why are you jizzing on your pictures, man?
Right. Hot, and I wrote her 20 more times. But
you made me a
never,
man.
Never got nothing on that. Never got nowhere.
Get up in those guts. That's like, a pretty crude way to put it. Let me get up in those guts.
Yeah. Bitch.
Yeah, you gotta add the bitch.
Bitch.
We are way off track.
Yeah.
I don't think we were ever on track.
I don't know. I didn't know. I never knew there was a track.
I think this episode's going pretty good.
Excellent. I like to hear
it's
that.
Decent.
Decent.
It's a good time.
Fucking decent.
I would fucking like to give mint a shout out to somebody who's not listening probably. Nah, but iPanda Radio liked our page on Instagram. Hey,
really?
They're like an internet radio show, so that's pretty cool.
Right
and
on.
Also, Sam awesome. Ash, Indianapolis, liked our shit too, so that's cool.
Nice.
Fuck yeah.
Except I haven't been to Sam Ash out here. Have you?
There's one up north.
Yeah.
Not out here, but yeah, there's one.
I used to go to Sam Ash back when I lived in California, but
I went there once. I thought it was
meh.
Ashy
Larry up in there.
No, I'm just kidding. It's like Guitar Center. I mean, it's like
right, right.
Thing.
Yeah, yeah, same thing.
It's the Walmart for music. So.
Yeah. Appreciate all the support we can get, though.
Fuck yeah.
I know,
that's
that was,
right.
That was cool of them.
That was cool.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
We mentioned them, now they have to mention us. That's the rule.
Right.
That's how it
works. Fucking break that law.
You forget, Walmart's pretty good, so, you know.
Right.
Big company.
Right. Someone needs to take down Walmart, man. They're too big.
Fuck yeah.
We need like a building mart or something.
I thought Hooters was going to be
a building mart.
Just yes. let Meyer have it for a while. Come on, Walmart. Jeez.
I think we're
right.
In competition with them.
Meyer Mart.
Yeah, but there's nowhere near as many Meyers as there is Walmarts.
Right.
Because that's more of just a Midwest thing.
You ever been to a Winn-Dixie?
Uh-uh.
The best thing ever.
In Florida.
Hey, you can move that mic back if you want.
Oh,
it hard. Moves.
A Winn-Dixie?
Winn-Dixie. Yeah, I was drunk. I called it Winn-Dickley's one time.
Dick
Winn-Dickley.
Dick Winn-Dickley.
That's how I said it, too.
Dick
Winn-Dickley. Now my Kentucky's coming out, dude. Like,
went down there to Winn-Dickley.
Shit Brixie.
Shit Brixie.
Shit-diculous.
That's shit-diculous. I'll tell you what.
I'll tell you what.
He does it real good.
I've been doing it my whole life.
Oh my god.
It's so funny. Damn it, Bobby.
Wingo. How was that one? Not as good?
Put Peggy on the phone.
You don't know me, but I know you.
Damn. Oh, shit.
Hey, Joseph. Ah, I fucked that up.
Who's your candy man, Connie? Connie, I'm your candy man.
Freaking idiots.
Oh, God, it just got
real.
Hey,
we got like 15 minutes left. I prepared a song if you want to do the segment.
Oh, the...
Since we did an episode where we fucking read some lyrics.
Oh, yeah.
And just talked about them and shit, but it accidentally got deleted.
He says accident.
Keith fucked it up. But...
Somebody fucked up. That's what I'm gathering from that.
Fuck ups happen.
I don't know if it was you or you, but somebody fucked up.
You think that's enough time to do it?
Oh, yeah. Depending on the song.
It's a good song.
Is it Freebird?
Free my bird.
Well, no. In or out.
And that's why we're not about allowed back in Target.
My bird was doing this.
God.
I think it's bird. It went like this.
Alright. Well, let's do it then.
Let's fucking cool. do it.
What's right. the song you got?
Alright, since, damn, Keith.
Just squeaking over here.
You're the one talking about your bird.
Squeaky Nick Squeakerson over here.
Alright, so, since it was a Tool song that I picked last time, but it got deleted, so, I picked another Tool song, but not the same one. Same album, different song. It's called Ride Into. How do you know it?
Ride Into.
To woo woo. You guys know it?
Not all fan.
Oh, I think he's out to see the wizard.
Yeah. All right. All right, so here we go. The first couple lines says, angels on the sideline, puzzled and amused.
Angels on the sideline.
Have you read these lyrics?
No, I haven't heard. I've heard the song, but I haven't like read the lyrics.
Right. You're probably gonna like it.
Is this from the new album?
It's from the previous album, 10,000 Days.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's called Ride In Two. Okay. Angels on the sideline, puzzled and amused. Why did Father give these humans free will? Now they're all confused.
Oh, shit.
Ooh, that's deep, huh?
Oh, shit.
That'll make you think.
So, yeah, it's like...
So he's just sitting there
it's
like,
kind of a
religious
perspective a little
so,
bit.
So it's like the angel sitting there going like, why the fuck did he do that? Now look at them. They're all fucking...
Yeah. The angel's sitting around and... why did he give them free will? And then next it says, don't these talking monkeys know that Eden has enough to go around? Plenty in this holy garden, silly old monkeys. Where there's one, you're bound to divide it right in two.
Oh, shit.
It's about humans fucking and conflict and, you know, war. Warring with each other, what's the point?
Yeah, and they're like, dude, you had Eden. There was
you
enough.
You had Eden.
You had it all.
He told you not to do you're one just... thing. You couldn't touch one fucking tree. You couldn't even do that, you dumb monkey.
It was the nicest looking tree, okay?
It
just looks so good.
What was that Family Guy thing where he's like, well, why can't we touch that tree? And he had like his porn behind him. He's like, just don't. Just leave it alone.
Sweeps it behind.
You gotta fuck shit up.
Alright. So next, hold on. We may have something happening right here.
Yeah, we got something happening here.
Breaking news.
Breaking.
Give us breaking.
Just in.
Breaking.
What did you think of on the wizard?
Tiny bubbles. Lot of tiny bubbles.
Do you play that game where you like shoot the bubbles man. With your pee? You're like,
see how many you can pop. Yeah.
Just an amazing amount of bubbles.
Or the where you try to fill the whole bowl up with bubbles. Anybody
yeah,
ever
done,
do that?
I've done that one.
Yeah,
I've done that one. I haven't done the one where you try to pop them, but I've done the one where you try to like fill it up.
It's like you pinch it and you go pew, pew.
What the entire fuck?
You're one of them messy peers.
I've never once tried
only
to pinch
me.
My
yeah,
dick.
Only one.
That's like, probably. I've never
cut
done that.
Cut that shit off.
No.
Oh, come on.
You're the only one. That sounds like it.
Until now.
you ever do the pre-flush?
Oh,
where
yeah.
You're whizzing, and then you hit the flusher because you're almost done whizzing. You got to force it out before it's all gone.
Yeah.
You do that? No?
When I'm standing there and I'm trying to force it out, I try to make sure I flush it with my force.
I've never had to force anything.
You're peeing, and then I'm almost done, so you start flushing, but then you pee the rest out real quick before it all goes down. You never do that?
Because
sometimes it flushes all the way and then it comes back up and it's already done the whole flush and you're still peeing. You're like, you win this
fuck
time.
Yeah. So anyways, back to the song.
Yeah.
Got a little sidetracked with the wizard. We're doing Ride In 2. I don't know if you... Yeah, you heard that, right? So anyways... Okay, Angels on the sideline, baffled and confused. Father blessed them all with reason, and this is what they choose. So, basically in the song, he's been talking about like Eden and how they created humans, and now he gave them free will, and now they're all fucking at war with each other and shit like that. Like, fucking up the world and that kind of shit. And then it goes, monkey killing monkey over pieces of the ground.
Monkey killing monkey killing.
I know, it's hard not to sing it.
I've seen you try to do it.
That's like pieces of the ground, literally.
Yeah, it's all made from dirt.
They're killing, like, I own this land.
Right?
Yeah.
Right.
This land is my land.
This land is your land.
This land's not yours.
California to the New York. What a piece of shit.
Yeah,
fuck school.
School's for nerds.
Fuck that is.
Silly monkeys, give them thumbs. They forge a blade, and where there's one, they're bound to divide it right in two.
The sun.
Was it talking about pussy?
It's all a metaphor
monkeys,
for pussy.
You would think about the three monkeys with a, hear no evil, see no evil.
Monkey pussy.
I don't know. I heard divide in two.
That's kind of fun to say.
Pussy lips immediately. I was like, well, they're
monkey pussy.
Two of those, right?
Oh. Okay, monkey killing monkey over pieces of the ground. Silly monkeys, give them thumbs. They make a club and beat their brother down.
Damn.
Trying to obtain dominance right there.
Yeah.
How they survive so misguided is a mystery. Repugnant is a creature who would squander the ability to lift an eye to heaven, conscious of this fleeting time here.
It's getting pretty
Cut
spiritual now, bro.
Right
I like it. I'm digging it.
Right into.
Cut it all right into. Right into!
Oh, dude.
Okay. I'll power through it. Fight over the clouds, over wind, over sky, and fight over blood, over life. Oh, I fucked that up. Over air and light. Over love, over sun, over another. Fight for the time. Fight for the one, for the rise, and angels on the sideline again.
They'll fight for anything and everything.
Been so long with patience and reason.
I mean, I'm angels. Pretty sure Maynard's Catholic from what I'm hearing.
Angels on the sideline again. I don't know, man.
I don't know either. I mean, he's definitely got a spiritual.
I don't know
if
he believes in God.
Oh, well, I mean, talking about Eden. I mean, there's only one book out there that talks about Eden.
I mean,
angels
so,
on
not
the
sure.
sideline again.
Eating.
Wondering when this tug of war will end. So, Okay, yeah. That's basically...
Was it Eden or was it Eden?
Eden.
It was Eden.
Yeah,
Eden.
You're right.
Yeah.
But,
So, yeah, I don't know, man. I mean,
but there's like a Perfect Circle songs where he's talking about how his mother died and how she was like super religious. But he was like, why are you super religious when he puts you in a wheelchair and shit for half your life? Or I don't know what it was, but.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, kinda, shit, dude. You can blame anybody for anything, dude. I mean,
right.
A lot of people like to blame God. You're the reason I'm here right now. Well, oh, God. I ain't like, no. Hey, that ain't working.
Life happens to all of us.
Yeah.
Ain't shit we can do about it, so.
Just enjoy it, man. Enjoy the ride.
Exactly.
It's fucking way she goes.
All you can do. Yeah, I'll do like lyrics of that song. Yes.
Get in the passenger seat, man, and don't put a seatbelt on. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a
like, yeah, it's a pretty deep song.
Yeah, man.
What's the one I did last time? The alien one, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was fun.
The one where you got abducted. Dun, 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 dun. She's like, what the fuck, man?
We still have a few minutes. I don't know how much we'll do that lyrics thing, but...
If we ever find
just
a good
like
song.
Every once in a while, probably.
Yeah.
So, what are y'all getting into? Rest of the night.
Man, I don't know. To be honest, I foresee lottery tickets, cocaine, and strippers. At least I hope.
Yeah, right.
Somehow.
In lottery tickets, cocaine, and strippers.
I mean, the lottery tickets, whatever, but cocaine and strippers.
I don't know why, that just reminded me of that.
Cocaine.
Did you guys ever see that video where the guy... It was like live news, and they're going up to a gas station or something, and somebody was buying like lottery tickets, and it was like a big Powerball, and he was like, "Well, what are you gonna do if you win?" And he's like, "I'm gonna buy a bunch of cocaine and strippers."
Yeah, I remember that. That shit was on the news.
Yeah.
He was serious as a kid.
Like a gangster.
Dude, he didn't miss a beat, bro. He was like, "I'll tell you what I'm gonna do with this shit.
Exactly what I'm gonna
buy a bunch of cocaine and strippers.
We'll be doing rails off fucking chicks' asses here in a minute."
To me, it sounded like an invite.
I know, man. I was like, where does this dude live?
That guy's my new best friend.
Just to be honest.
Right, man. Trying to look him up on Facebook and shit. Like,
if I don't want it, I want him
who
to.
Who is this guy?
Right.
He's got the right idea.
Man. I heard Akon.
But no, I don't. Man, just chilling, I guess.
I heard Akon bought and built a city and called it Akon City.
Acorn City. That. Oh, I did read that too.
That's fucked up. Acorn City.
But then, like Zootopia or something. Shit.
Acorn City.
I can feel it creeping in the. How's it go? Shadow. Why don't you hump in my Lamborghini Gallardo?
I don't think I.
Smack that L on the floor. Smack that. Give me some more.
I don't remember any Akon.
Bullshit.
All I can remember
he blew
is
up.
All I can remember is Akon of Young Jesus.
Yeah, that's what I was getting out.
Trying to
God.
Smoke a bleezy.
Trying to take it easy. All I can remember of Akon.
Take it sleazy.
And I used to get him and is it Maroon 5? That dude. I used to get
Adam Levine.
When they're singing, to me they sound exactly the same. I cannot differentiate.
No.
And it's, I have no idea.
I can see what you're saying, yeah. That is really weird. I never thought about that.
Because they, I don't know. I'll be like, oh, is this new Akon? They're like, this fucking like Maroon 5 or something, whatever it is.
How weird would that would have been, dude.
Keith. I thought that was Akon.
Sound like a Muppet.
Adam Levine, dude.
I don't know. I can't remember the words to the song.
Levine and Young Jesus. I mean, that's what it could have been, dude. I mean.
Just try to take it easy.
Maroon 5 and Young Jesus.
Right.
So, about to wrap it up here, but I wanted to tell you that Brandon is confirmed for 31st.
Okay.
We'll have him on.
Cool.
Yeah, I'll be there.
But this.
Not kidding.
Oh yeah, different Brandon. I'm sorry. We have another Brandon in the room.
He's like, I did not confirm.
I can be there. Don't worry.
But so we have this episode comes out on the 20th. We're going to need one more week in between there. One more episode. Just let you know that.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks to our guests.
It's been fun,
for
man.
Coming
much
on.
Appreciated.
Yeah, listen, awesome. Hey, I just want to know, though, when we get done with this, can we still, like, keep the headphones on and talk like this?
Dude, I was going to ask you if you want to do another one.
We can do next week's already?
Because we need part two episodes.
Yeah, we need to.
Another 2 hours.
He comes over, like, every other week, so.
Yeah.
Fuck, we're about out of
time, bro. We ain't got nothing but time.
All right, then. We'll do round two here in a few.
Round two here in a few.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Sweet deal.
Well, thank you everybody to those who listen.
Yeah, subscribe really to our YouTube. Fucking like and share and bullshit. Hey, is it cool to tag you guys and share and tag you guys in this shit or what?
Absolutely, bro.
Cool, we'll do that.
Hey, this is my first time ever on mic like this. I was nervous all day, so sorry for
that's
that.
All right.
No, man.
Hey, I had a good time.
Yeah.
Appreciate you guys coming out. It's real fun.
It's been, how much time do we have? Never mind.
No, I'm wrapping it up right now. But
going into part two. I'll tell you this joke, guys, in part two.
All right, don't forget, peace. Man. Don't forget.
No, I won't. Yeah.
Dude, all right. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, guys.
Peace out.
Peace out.
'Day there's a podcast waiting for me from my friends at Distorted Minds.